trying to bring awareness to the locker room, to the community, to the fan base. I think that this is a huge step, and giving us space to talk, you know, because I think that's the most important part.
Hi, Louisa. How's it going?
Hi, Brock. It's okay. Thank you. How are you?
I'm good. Thank you. Excited to have you here.
I'm excited to be here.
Louisa, why don't we start off by having you tell everyone who you are?
Okay. So, hi, guys. I'm Louisa. I work for NHL Brazil, and I also work for Last Word on Sports. I'm a writer there for the NHL. And yeah, I'm a hockey fan, watching it, suffering about it. So yeah, it's beautiful.
Awesome. And we're lucky to have you. How did Louisa get into hockey?
I read some books, that, like some romances about hockey, and I wanted to start watching it. So a couple of friends that are Americans, they introduced me to it. I started watching junior hockey actually first. And then last year I wanted to write a book about it, like a romance that goes with hockey. And I started Googling about it and started watching games, and I ended up falling in love with it. So now I'm here.
That's so cool. And is your romance book out?
What?
Did you finish your romance book? Is it out?
Yeah, it's out, but it's in Portuguese because I'm Brazilian, but it's out on Amazon. The second one is actually coming out next week, so I'm really excited.
Very cool. What do you love about hockey?
I think everything, like the sport makes you rush, you know, like makes your heart beat faster because it's so fast. It's so different from everything we have here in Brazil. And I think that the community, even though a couple of people are toxic and it's kind of weird sometimes, but like we have such an amazing community here in Brazil. And my team, like everyone from America and Canada, has been so supportive. So I think that this, like, you know, the community, the sport, I think that as a whole, it has its problems, of course, but I love it.
Yeah, community seems to be a common theme. And I think it's especially prevalent online, and people build community, and then they build their own little pockets of people, right? And we see that everywhere, just like you've helped build in Brazil, and it's so incredible and exciting to see. That said, based off your intersection of identities, how could hockey be better for you? And also, how could it be better for the queer community as a whole?
I think that hockey is starting to change now because it has been such a wide sport, a male sport, like in general. So I think that it's starting to change slowly now, more than it was like years ago. So I think that there's a lot to change. Like, first of all, we don't see a lot of queer people in hockey. We don't see players, we don't see reporters, we don't see coaches and etc. We see more on the women's hockey league, but we don't see it in the NHL and in the male part. So I think that trying to bring awareness to the locker room, to the community, to the fan base, I think that this is a huge step. And giving us space to talk, you know, because I think that's the most important part. You can't put a straight man to talk about queer people and to talk about the LGBTQI+ community. So like giving space to us so we can talk, so we can teach, so we can try to make a change and like hire more people that is in the community, so we can try to like make a change from the inside, because I think that's the most important part. Because like players can wear the rainbow in one night, in the pride night, but what really matters is how the community will change from the inside to the outside. So we see like players like Curtis Gabriel, that is a huge ally, and that is so important that he's picking with his teammates and with people that is like that go talk to him. You're so important. So I think that this is like a step that we're taking, but it's always baby steps, and sometimes it feels like we take a huge step back and it's hard, you know. But I think that giving us voice and giving us space to talk and to teach is really important.
Thank you for the kind words, and I couldn't agree more, you know, that education component, the humanization education and sharing our experiences matters, and it'll evolve things. Knowing we take these steps forward and then steps back, what keeps you in hockey?
I think that knowing that I can be an example for the people who come after me. Because I think that I say this about feminism, I say this about the fight that we have with the LGBTQ+ community, but it's also, we're not exactly building something for us here in the present, we're building for the people who will come after us, just like the past built for us so we could be open and talk about it. So I think that what motivates me to stay here and to keep watching and to keep talking about it is trying to make a small change now, so that the future me's and you's can make a bigger change, make a bigger impact, and be open about who they are and about their personalities and their sexualities. I think that's it. Because sometimes it's so tiring. We look at everything that happens. We see players using slangs, and it makes you like, oh, can't believe this is happening again. But then I remember what you told us in our interview on Monday, that it's a thing that is so inside a locker room that sometimes they don't even know that there is something that is outside of it. So I think that's it. Like, what motivates me is like, I can make a change. So if I leave, who's gonna make it? You know, because we're so little inside of our community, even though we're like hundreds, it's so little compared to all the toxic people that is out there. So I think that trying to make a change here is what motivates me.
And I'm grateful that you're here and making change on a daily basis. In making the change and seeing the culture and seeing the online communities, what gives you hope for queer people in the sport looking ahead, looking forward?
I think that with the internet and with people being so open about their sexualities, about their opinions, I think that there's a high probability that things will start to change. Like, players are not stupid. They are on the internet, so they can have access. Fans are not stupid. They have access. So I think that even if one person looks at what we're doing here right now and sees us speaking about it and sees us being open about it, and maybe this person can change, then I think it's a step forward, you know? So I think that the internet has a huge impact on what is going to happen next.
I sure hope so.
Yeah.
You know, but people like you give me hope, and what you're creating in a non-traditional hockey market is so incredible. And, you know, just that type of diversity alone, and then the intersections with being queer and everything else, is just so powerful. Louisa, is there anything you'd like to add?
Just be brave to anybody who's watching us right now or will read. I don't know how you guys are going to publish this. Just, and they are doubting themselves and don't want to talk about their sexualities and the things they believe in. Just be brave, because there are thousands of people out there who will support you and who will be by your side and who will fight your fight with you. So I think that's it. Because at the beginning, I was kind of scared to talk about my sexuality, to talk about how I'm bi. So just, I know it's scary, and I know it's a really complicated market, and I know it's, sometimes you feel like it's not worth it, but it totally is. There's a huge platform that will support you and that will be by your side. And yeah, that's it. Don't give up on hockey. We can make a change together.
And follow NHL Brazil.
Yeah, and follow NHL Brazil, exactly.
Thank you, Louisa. I appreciate you and everything you're doing.
Appreciate you guys. Thank you so much for doing this.